Welcome back, everyone. In this episode, we're going to be lighting the warp engines. Got the two halves here that are going to be lit up. Just got to remove the masking tape on the inner and outer sides there, and then I can start putting the lights in. Looks good. But, then it's gonna look real nice. It focuses. There we go. Anyway. I had a bit of a boo-boo here. I guess when I was cutting out those little notches in here, I drilled too deep and it gored a hole right in here. So I put some of the window maker in there, gotta let it dry, and it'll hide it a little bit, but obviously not enough. But oh well, it happens. I got these sides here are the outer sides here. Now this one goes with this one. Now in order to light this up, I'm going to be putting in lights on this side here. And the lights that I'm going to use for that are the HF 3mm. Are these little babies right here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to chain link them all along here for about the length that this is, all the way down. Basically, going to just put the side by side and then mark on this side here from what end to what end, and then just chain link them all the way down. Which could take 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, probably about almost a dozen for each side. Okay, now on my mat here, I mark the points here, here, and here, as to how long the lighting here has to be. So they're going to be pretty close together. And all the way down, so it's going to take about a dozen each on for each side to do. Okay, so I got them all out there. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it's going to take 18 of these in total to light up both warp engines. Now, with these particular lights, easy way to find out which side is positive and negative is to see this side here that has the two little holes here, that's the positive side, and this side here that's all solid is negative. So just keep the poles on the same all the way down, and you'll have yourself a nice looking little daisy chain. There you go, there's the daisy chain. Do a quick lighting test. Very good. Works great. Got to install it into the first warp engine. There we go. We're both done. Ready for installation. There we go. We're all glued in place. Pretty good. Not bad. Alright. And do another quick lighting test here. Not bad. It's going to be a lot brighter than that, though, too. warp engines are looking good. Just a few more lights to install and these things are ready to be put together. I'm gonna take these, glue these in place here. I came up with an issue where the little holes here for the lighting, these are going to be covering the holes, so I have to drill through this for the holes here. There we go. Just using the glue gun, glued those in place, and they're in there real hard, so they're not going anywhere. I'm going to put the other half over top, and then I can re-drill the holes. The little spot there where there was a hole in the grate there, I just went and got a little bit of white glue and I filled it up. I got it about as level as I could, and then after it dries, just cut off the excess and then repaint the areas in black. And hopefully it should mesh right in and you would hardly see it, that there was even a hole there. For the inside here, for the warp grills, I just lightly painted a light blue color on the inside. So you got, let's see, it shines through as a blue color. On the warp engine here, I marked out the area for the painting. I figured, you know, get the painting done now before it's on the model. It's gonna be a whole lot easier. Warp engine's coming along. Little bit to do yet, not a whole lot. Looks good. Just gotta do this section here on both warp engines, and these babies are done. Well, almost. Now, on this portion of the warp engine, this small section here lights up. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to drill that rounded part out, fill it up with that window maker, and then I can light it later. There we go, all done. Just gotta let it dry and then I can put lights in there. Et voila, there we go. Not too bad, looking good. Just gotta finish off the lighting and then I can put these puppies together. Two more white RL5 5mm white LEDs are going to be installed here for this area, which is right there. But before I can install those, I'm going to flatten them down so that they fit better. So I'm just going to tie these points in with these lights here. Okay, so let's see, I got positives this side, negatives this side. So I'm going to make sure I get this right. Thank you. test looks good. You see it lit up there. Not bad, eh? Looks good. There we go. All finished. Both of them complete for that. Now I just need to get the some fiber optic lines run here for the thruster ports here. I'm using a 0.30 fiber optic line to put in there and to run to the LED, which I think I'm just going to use a yellow. Okay. Wait a sec here. So I'm just going to tie these lights in with these warp engine grill lights. Actually, I can probably just tie them in. Right down here. Yeah, okay. See how long I need it here. That a little too long, but not long enough. Dry overnight. Could be just a bit of a problem with this one. See, the problem with these thicker fiber optic lines is if you go to bend them, these ones tend to snap compared to the thinner ones. You gotta be really, 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 really careful. Alright, so I got that all done. Added that on the end now. I use some heat shrink here to create a shunt for the fiber optics to go to the light, the thruster ports, and there you have it. It'll be a little bit brighter than that because all I'm using right now is a 3-volt power source, but that looks good. There we go. Got that lit up now. Yeah, just added a big 5 mil white, and it looks good. I got the navigational lighting in now. So that's all done. I think these warp engines are all lit up now. I just gotta run the lines. And I can close these babies up. There we go. Got all the wiring done. So I got the yellow and white is for the flasher. Black and red are just for the constant lights. So, time to put these two puppies together. And there we have it, folks. Everything all put together. But then, sadly enough, that's it for this episode. In the next one, we're going to be working on the struts and begin assembly, or the final assembly of the model. So please like, subscribe, and comment. And if you have any questions or you want me to do some commission work for you, please contact me at modelbuilder501@yahoo.ca. See you later, everyone.